This third video in the series will show you how to do an inventory using the Water Master survey. Once you have fired up the survey, click on a water source and the version name. You can see that this diversion is an open channel. Since the inventory will vary slightly for open channels and closed conduit devices, I will show you both, starting with the open channel. Click on inventory and uncheck measurement. You can see that there are six main sections of an inventory. Click on the little arrow on the left-hand side to expand each one of them. We will start with the general inventory information section. The survey identifies diversions by name. However, often diversions have not been given a name yet, and instead IDWR will identify it by a number. Next, provide the description of the diversion. Indicate whether the diversion was active at the time of the visit, and whether the diversion appears to be active this season at all. If you answer no, it will ask you to use the drop-down and provide a possible reason for not diverting water. Next, in the Pictures section, you can take up to 5 pictures. Because I am using the Survey123 app on my computer for this video, I can only see the folder icon, which allows me to attach documents. On a mobile device, as shown in the inset here, you can click on the picture icon and it will open the camera on your phone. The pictures you take will be stored with the rest of the survey information you collect. Check out the fourth video in this series, where I will show you how to look at the results and at the pictures that you take here. The next section asks you about the measurement device that is installed. Since you picked open channel earlier, the measurement portion of the inventory will ask you questions specifically for a measurement device for an open channel. The first question asks you if there is a measurement device. If there is not, then you are done with the questions here and you can move on to the next section. If there is, it will ask you the type of measuring device. Depending on the type you pick, you will get more specific follow-up questions about that device. For example, let's click on weir. It will then ask you from a list of different types of weirs. Based on the type of weir you pick, it will ask you for the dimensions of the measuring device. The same order of questions appears if you pick a different measurement device, for example, a flume. It will ask you a little bit more information about the type of flume and then the dimensions for this measuring device. If the device type is not listed, simply click on Other, and you will have access to some text fields to describe the measurement device as well as the dimensions of this measurement device. The last question for an open channel measuring device asks you if the device is in good condition or not. If it is not, it will ask you a follow-up question to ask you what is wrong with the measurement device. Now let's switch over to a closed conduit measurement device. Notice that the title of the section changed from measurement device open channel to measurement device closed conduit. The first question again is if there is even a measurement device. If there's not, then there's no point asking you more questions about it. If there is, it will ask you what type of measurement device. If you choose either time clock, alternate, or other, it will simply present you with a text box to provide a comment before you can move on to the next section. For both the flow meter and the PCC, there will be more specific questions. Let's start with the PCC. You will be asked to specify the manufacturer, as well as the PCC condition description, and a text box to provide more information. When you pick a flow meter, different questions appear. It will ask you the meter type. Based on this meter type, it will present you with a list of manufacturers. And then present you with a list of models that are made by that specific manufacturer. The survey maintains a list of IDWR approved closed conduit devices. This list not only specifies the models, but also provides installation and other notes for the proper installation of those meters. For information purposes, we have included those notes in the survey and set it up that you only see the notes that pertain to the meter that you just picked. Next, provide a serial number, a rate unit, rate multiplier, volume unit, volume multiplier, as well as information about the pipe material, the pipe wall thickness in inches, the outside diameter in inches, the upstream distance and the downstream distance. There may be a metal tag located near the pump. If you can find that tag, please specify the tag number as well as a comment about where you found the tag. Who would be the person to contact if there's any follow-up about this flow meter? Is the flow meter working? Click on the drop-down next to the flow meter status to indicate whether the meter is working, the first option, or if not, what is wrong. If this happens to be a mechanical meter, you can click on option 9. Finally, you will be given the opportunity to add any other comments. There is a third and last measurement device scenario. Let me pull that up. We have covered the open channel measurement device and the closed conduit measurement device. The last scenario is shown here, where you can see that the measurement device is in our WMIS system, which is short for the Water Measurement Information System. Our WMIS system already has a lot of measurement device inventory information, so instead of collecting this information, we ask you to double check the information we already have. It starts out by asking if the measurement type is correct. In this case, according to WMIS, it is a flow meter that is used for irrigation. If that is the case, you can provide the new contact information. If it is no longer the case, click No and the survey will start collecting information about the new measurement device. Let's click No and see how that works. First, you will be asked what type of device is installed. You can tell, for example, if I click PCC, that the questions that appear are more extensive than the PCC questions you were asked earlier for a closed conduit measurement device that was not part of the WMIS system. If you pick Flow Meter 9, which is ironically not a flow meter at all, but rather an open channel device, it will proceed to ask you to provide contact information, and you are also given a box to provide a comment. Because this is an open channel measurement device, the measurement device open channel section has been added to your survey. Those are the same questions that you looked at earlier. Let's go back and assume that, yes, this is still a flow meter used for irrigation. If you find that any information is incorrect or missing, you can add that. When I look at this text here, I can tell that the pipe material and the wall thickness are both missing. Also, the upstream and downstream distance are missing. So let me go down and where it asks me which items need to be added or changed, I can click the pipe material, the wall thickness, the outside diameter, the upstream distance and the downstream distance. As I click those answers, the questions for those items will appear below. Finally, you are asked what the meter status is. If this is a working meter, click 1 again. If not, then you can indicate what is wrong with it. And you can also add a site visit. Any information you have changed or added in this section should be updated in the WMIS system as well. So when you look at this survey next year, this information is correct. Updating this information in the WMIS system can be done manually or automatically. Please contact IDWR if you would like to learn more about automatically adding this information to our WMIS system. The last three sections of the inventory are the same regardless of the type of diversions or measurement device. The headgate information asks you about the presence of a headgate. If there is a headgate, click Yes and it will ask you if this headgate is lockable, as well as the adequacy of the control structure. Next, it will ask you if there is a fish screen present, and if you click Yes, it will ask you if this fish screen is located above or upstream of the measurement device or below it. The water right information section asks you to tell a little bit more about what the water for each water right is used for, and also allows you to add a specific comment for each water right. Finally, the location information. The location source will tell you whether the location came from IDWR's databases or, for example, from GPS coordinates provided by a watermaster. Click on the map to make it bigger. If it looks good, do not touch it and click on the arrow in the top left corner. If it does not look quite right, you can zoom in and out on your computer by scrolling the little wheel on top of your mouse forward and backward. Moving your fingers apart will zoom in the map, moving your fingers together will zoom it out. To have the map move to your current physical location, click on My Location button. While the orange pin will remain in the middle of the screen, you can move the map behind it so that the pin is directly on top of your diversion. When you are happy with the location, click on the check mark to return to the main survey. Finally, the survey will give you the public land survey system description. Now that you are done with the survey, you can click on the checkbox and choose to send the survey now or send it later. Thank you for watching this video.